गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम इन दिस क्लास। दिस इज क्लास 8, सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस एंड इट इज द सेकेंड लेक्चर ऑफ चैप्टर सेकेंड ऑफ हिस्ट्री, दैट इज ट्रेड टू टेरिटरी। ये स्टूडेंट्स, एज द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर डिनोट्स दैट द चैप्टर इज अबाउट द जर्नी ऑफ द ब्रिटिश रूल इन इंडिया, मीन्स द चैप्टर टेल्स अस दैट हाउ ब्रिटिशर्स केम इन इंडिया, मीन्स दे For what purpose they came and when they came and how they became the ruler of India. Means as we know that the Britishers came in India for trading purpose and they became the ruler of India. So in today's lecture, the topics which are to be discussed are like this. First is there, that is how trade led to Battle of Plassey, Battle of Buxar and Diwani Raj. But before the discussions on the following topics in today's lecture, first we will recapitulate our previous topics which we discussed in our yesterday lectures. So friends, yesterday we discussed about that means how the Britishers entered in India and for what purpose they came in India. Actually friends, the British power began to merge or began to come in India from the second half of the 18th centuries, and the British actually they came in India for trading purpose, means they were originally as a small trading company like East India Company, and ultimately they became the master of the vast territory, and it took a very long time. And how it happened? Actually, it happened when in 1600 the East India Company acquired a charter means written permission, yes, from the ruler of England, Queen Elizabeth I, granting it the sole right to trade with East. It means in 1600, the East India Company got a written permission to trade with India, and it was the only company those who got this permission. So but when this company came in India for trading, so before its arrival, many other European trading companies already had entered in India, and these were like Portuguese, Dutch, okay, French. So beta, and all these companies, they wanted to buy the same things, like such as fine qualities of cotton, silk, means these things, fine quality of cotton, silk and the spices of India, these things were very famous in the world, and all these companies wanted to buy these things. So for this competition, amongst this company pushed up the price, means rises the prices of the things. This is there, and in which East India Company became or risen up the more powerful. And for that, when it started its trade, first it started its trade with Bengal, and for that in 1696, first in 1651 it set up a English factory at the bank of river Hooghly, and in 1696 it began building a fort around the settlement. This is there. And beta, as we have already studied about the medieval period and about Aurangzeb, as we know that Aurangzeb was the last powerful Mughal emperor, and the Aurangzeb that he gave a farman, Farman is granting the company the right to trade duty free. What was this farman? Actually, it was also a written permission, and according to this farman, the company was given the right to trade with India without paying any tax. Means trading without paying any taxes. This is there. But beta, after the death of Aurangzeb, his grandson, that is Siraj-ud-Daulah, his grandson Siraj-ud-Daulah became the Nawab of Bengal, and he was a great enemy of Britisher. He never liked the Britishers and their policies, their plans, okay, about India. So he refused to all grant the company concession. What does it mean? Actually, the concessions, the facilities like duty, free trade, and these types of facility or this type of concessions which were given by the Aurangzeb to the company. So when Sirajuddaulah became the Nawab, he refused to give all these types of concessions to the company. This is there. And he also ordered the Britishers to pay revenue and stop fortification. This is there. And but the company denied for it. And this made Sirajuddaulah angered. And he declared a war against Britishers. Okay. So means when he declared a war against Britishers, what did he do? Means when company denied, or means after negotiation failed, the Nawab or Sirajuddaulah marched with 30,000 soldiers. He means with his 30,000 soldiers to the he attacked on English factory at Kasim Bazar. One English factory was there which was set up in Madras, Kasim Bazar. So for that, means Sirajuddaulah, first he attacked on this English factory, and where he captured all the company officials, he locked the warehouse and disarmed all Englishmen and blockaded English ship. This is there. So, but on hearing the news of the fall of Calcutta, company's official in Madras sent forces under the command of Robert Clive. Means when company got this news of the fall of Calcutta, then he also sent its forces under the leadership of Robert Clive. Okay, this is there. And means Robert Clive. And so a war was fought between Robert Clive and Britishers. This was known as Battle of Plassey. Okay, so means this incident, which incident? Means when the Sirajuddaulah attacked on the their factories. So this incident infuriated English or East India companies. Means got angered. Infuriated, got angered. Means due to this incident, East India Company got angered and the famous Battle of Plassey began in 1757. So when Battle of Plassey was fought? In 1757. And it was fought between who? Bengal Nawab Sirajuddaulah and the Robert Clive, who was the British officials. Yes, students, but in this war, in this battle, Sirajuddaulah was defeated by Britishers with the help of Mir Zafar. Who was this Mir Zafar? And what was the reason of the defeat of Sirajuddaulah? Yes, now we will discuss about it. Reason behind the defeat of Sirajuddaulah. Actually, Mir Zafar was one of the commanders of Sirajuddaulah's. Okay, and the British, or you can say East India Company, that made promise ki if we will win the war, so Mir Zafar would be declared as the Nawab of Bengal. This is there. So the main reason behind his defeat was that the Mir Zafar, one of the Sirajuddaulah's commanders, betrayed means deceived him and never fought the battle. Means he fought the battle for the British side he fought against Sirajuddaulah. This is there. Means he deceived the Sirajuddaulah in war and didn't go for fight in favor of Sirajuddaulah. This is there. So what happened after the Battle of Plassey? Yes, as we know that in this battle, Sirajuddaulah was defeated by British. This is there. So after the defeat and death of Sirajuddaulah's, next one is there. Miss Mir Zafar became the Nawab of Bengal as Britishers promised him. So means after the death, after the Sirajuddaulah's, then who became the Nawab of Bengal? Mir Zafar. And the company was granted right to free trade in Bengal. Yes, again, Mir Zafar gave the same right. He again gave the permission or gave the right to the company to do trade without paying any taxes. this is there. Actually, Mir Zafar was the nominal head of Bengal. Means the actual or the all the power was in the hand of Britishers. So means after some times he refused to give further rights. What is this? Actually, day by day, the demands, the concession, demands of the concessions of the Britishers were increasing. So after some times when that Bengal Nawab refused to give further rights, then this thing created the situations of conflict between Nawab and company. So due to this, this company got angry and Jafar was dethroned from the Bengal. And in place of Jafar, new Nawab, Mir Qasim. And now, Miss Mir Qasim became the next Nawab of Bengal. But the same happened again, means after some times when he, Miss Mir Qasim, also complained against misuse of right. So it resulted the next war, that is Battle of Buxar, and which was fought in Mir Qasim and the Britisher in 1764. And again, in which there was the victory of the Britishers and Mir Qasim was defeated. So the Mir Qasim was defeated by Britisher in the Battle of Buxar. And the Mir Zafar was, again, the Mir Zafar was reinstalled. Means again, he was declared as the Nawab of Bengal. But Mir Zafar died in 1765. This is there. So after the death of Zafar, the mood of the company had changed. Actually, the company got fed up with the work of puppet Nawab and took a big and they decided to take a big decision. And what was this decision? He took a big decision. That decision was this, like, finally in 1765, means after the death of Mir Qasim, the Mughal Emperor Shah Alam means appointed the company as the Diwan of the provinces of Bengal. Diwan. Actually, beta, Diwan is the term which was used for a person who had the right of collection taxes. This is there. So now, means according to this Diwani right, the company got the right of collection of revenues or taxes in Bengal. And this is known as Diwani rights. And what was the benefits? What were the benefits of this Diwani right? So here one picture is given. Look there, in which the Mughal Emperor Shah Alam that granting the company Diwani right. Yes, the benefits of this Diwani right. First, students, you must know about the Diwani right. As I told you that Diwani right means the right of collection taxes or revenues. Yes, so Diwani right allowed the company to exploit the vast revenue of Bengal. Means now the company got the right to collect vast revenues from the Bengal. And so in this way, the overflow of gold from Britain stopped. What does it mean? Yes, friends, before this Diwani right, the Miss company dependent on government, Britain government, to purchase raw materials and for the other miss expenses. But now, after this Diwani right, now he had the source of income. Means he could collect the taxes. So he had money to purchase the things. So now, earlier he purchased this raw material with the exchange of gold and silvers which came from Britain. But after this Diwani right, the overflow of gold from Britain stopped. Now, revenue from India means the taxes which company collected from India or Bengal could finance company expenses. Means now this money, they could be used to fulfill their all needs or expenses. This is there. Yes, students. So in this way, so the many British officials, they became rich and the real Nawab of Bengal. Actually, now British official became the real Nawab of Bengal and the actual Nawab were forced to give land and vast sum of money as personal gifts to company's officials. This is there. And this rich people, wealthy people of company, those who took all the resources or money from India, they took this money from India and took away to the England, and there they led a very comfortable and luxurious life. And these peoples, this company's officials, were known as Nabobs, and in Hindi meaning Nawabs. This is there. Okay. Yes, students, so in this way our today's lecture is completed. Tomorrow we will again discuss the next topics of the chapter, like company rules expand and their policies, their plan and their administration system, and the changes which they made in administrations and their army. Now note down your homework. Yes, first question is there, who were called Nabobs? How did the Egyptians of Diwani benefit of East India Company? And third question, write a short note on Battle of Plassey. And why did the company want a puppet ruler? So this is your homework. Now we will discuss the homework. Solution of lecture first. What attracted European companies to India? Yes, the fine qualities of cotton and silk produced in India. Indian spices such as pepper, cloves, cardamom and cinnamon, they were famous in the world, and these things were there which attracted European companies to India. What were the areas of conflict between Bengal Nawab and East India Company? Yes, the Bengal Nawab asserted their power, autonomy, and they refused to grant the company concession. They demanded large tribute for the company's right to trade. They denied the company any right to mint coin, and they stopped the companies from extending its fortification. Yes, students, who was the ruler of England in 1600? Yes, Queen Elizabeth I. What caused huge loss of revenue in Bengal? Aurangzeb's Farman. As we know that Aurangzeb issued a Farman in which he granted the company only the right to trade duty free without paying tax. So, but the officials of the company also stopped paying duty, and this caused a huge loss of revenue for Bengals. So in this way our today's lecture is completed. Tomorrow we will meet again with our next lectures. Thank you.